talk for months now, but today some lawmakers officially discuss the possibility of impeaching Governor Mark Sanford.
This involves the governor disappearing last June to go to see his lover in Argentina. News 4's Mike McCormick is on the story live in Columbia tonight. Mike?
Well, Carolyn, Michael, this really is the very beginning. Today's hearing lasted only about an hour, and though there was some discussion involved, it was really about charging the panel with the task of being fair and setting an example for years to come.
This is important. There's no doubt about that.
Representative Gary Smith of Greenville County is on this seven-member panel charged with the first step in deciding if Governor Mark Sanford should be impeached.
I think that the committee is going to be very deliberative in their responsibilities.
They must decide if the governor's absence in June was serious misconduct in office. The state and the country later learned Sanford was unreachable in June because he was in Argentina visiting the woman with whom he was having an affair.
The governor intentionally and clandestinely evaded South Carolina law enforcement division agents assigned to secure his safety in order to effect his absence from the state. And that conduct alone constitutes a dereliction of duty.
Representative Greg Delaney said the governor went AWOL or absent without leave. That didn't sit well with another member of the panel.
It's a little shrill for a civilian to hear. The comments made, as far as I know, I, at this time, nor the governor are members of a military organization, and to speak about a dereliction of duty, absent without leave, abandoning one's post, are terms ordinarily reserved for those who are in uniform and who are not civilian.
The chairman said that discussion was allowed because the issue of the governor's absence was already public knowledge.
The sooner this issue has been fully resolved, the better off the state of South Carolina is.
Aside from the governor's absence, the panel will also discuss findings of an ethics investigation that accused the governor of 37 violations, including personal use of the state's plane.
I think the committee is also going to be very expeditious in the way that it handles things because there are a number of other important issues out that we have to get to also.
And discussions will begin again in early December. That's when the panel will take up the idea of those ethics violations, particularly the use of the state plane and the purchase of pricey airline tickets. Now, here's what the governor had to say about that when we caught up with him today in Charleston.
Well, I would simply say, as one who's done a little bit of reading on the subject, obviously, there have apparently been eight governors impeached in the history of the United States, all on major charges. If you look at using a business class ticket as the grounds on which to impeach, it'll certainly be new grounds. I'll leave it at that.
And before Christmas, the panel that met today hopes to make a report about its opinion on impeaching the governor to the judicial committee. The judicial committee then has to review it and give a recommendation to the House. We, of course, will keep you posted. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4, live tonight in Columbia.